acquired brain injury is anything that happens post-birth or after birth that causes damage or trauma to the brain.
They can be internal or external causes, external being a fall or a car accident or something of that nature where there's a trauma to the head, or it can be more of an internal process like a brain tumor, aneurysm or things like that, anything that happens inside a person's brain. A stroke is another example of an acquired brain injury. Psychologists and physicians rank head injuries and they call them mild, moderate, or severe head injuries. So there's quite a range, but it's not to be confused that a mild brain injury is in any way inconsequential. A traumatic brain injury is a subcategory of acquired brain injuries. What a traumatic brain injury means is there's some external force exerted on the head, like hitting your head on something or having something strike your head that causes damage to the brain, so it's traumatic in nature. Some common means by which individuals suffer a traumatic brain injury could be a motor vehicle crash, a fall, sport-related concussions, or other kinds of blunt force trauma to their head are very common causes of concussion all the way up to severe brain injuries. Non-traumatic acquired brain injuries are things like brain tumors, strokes, aneurysms, anoxic brain injuries where the brain is without oxygen for a period of time, drug-induced brain injuries where there's some internal process rather than some blunt force trauma to the head. The signs and symptoms of a brain injury are very widespread. There are generally three classes of symptoms or signs that an individual has following a brain injury. In terms of cognitive symptoms or thinking types of problems, an individual will often have short-term memory deficits where they can't form new memories efficiently. Concentration and attention is another common set of symptoms related to brain injury. And the general speed of a person's thinking is slowed down after a brain injury because the brain is operating at less than 100% efficiency while it's trying to recover from the injury. Physical symptoms can include things like headache, nausea, dizziness. You can see things like vomiting. There may be discharge from the ears or nose. That would be on the more severe level of a brain injury. And then also the third class is really emotional types of symptoms. So there could be a lot of emotional dysregulation, depression, anxiety, fear, or the lack of those things that occurs following a brain injury. The onset of symptoms can occur immediately, and often they do. But again, they can occur several days to several weeks later. The best example of that are frontal lobes, which develop throughout life, and they're really not fully operational until a